REIT, it is basically a stock. It's like a investment in the stock market. Except that it's a little bit of a hybrid stock investment. Parang hindi siya completely like a common stock. Hindi rin naman siya completely like a fixed income with a dividend. No? What I can suggest for investors is that to have a portfolio where it is part of your stock investment but more stable ang dividend niya. Kasi nga, more stable ang return niya. So, if you're going to invest in REIT, I would suggest that you include that in your stock portfolio. If your stock portfolio is like 20%, maybe around 5% for that, maybe a good way to start. You know, sa REITs, there are two types of returns that you are going to get from it. Ano? Number one is the dividend. The dividend is coming from the rental income that the REITs is generating, depending on the property that's in the REIT. So the rental income will be given to you as a form of dividend. And the other return that you will get from a REIT is really the appreciation of the price of the REIT that is listed in the stock exchange. So yung dalawang yon, pag samahin mo, that will be the total return. Now, an attractive return for me, no, is a dividend yield of at least 5%. Kasi nga, it is an investment that you want to have a more or less stable return. So a 5% at least on the dividend yield is good. And then plus a return on the price appreciation of the REIT itself. So maybe around 3-5% additional. So you will have a total return of more or less about 8-10%. Sana as a projected or a target return for the REIT. Then that would be attractive for investors. So, if you're investing in a REIT, there are two major things that you want to consider. One is the value that you're going to generate from the REIT. For example, what dividend rate are you going to get and the price of the REIT movement in terms of appreciation. So that's the value that you generate from the REIT. It really depends on the property and the lease rental that the property has. So kung okay yung occupancy rate niya, meaning lahat ng rent tenants are there and they're paying rent, and that should be okay. So it depends on the business or the property that it has. So kung nagkaroon ng crisis or nagkaroon ng problem yung rent itself, no, nabawasan ng tenants, nabawasan ng people who are renting in the property, bababa din yung income mo. So that's the risk that you have. So pag bumaba yung income nung REIT, bababa din yung value and price nung REIT. The second thing that you consider is how that value compares to other alternative investments. Like for example, a government security. If you compare that to a REIT, which is riskier than a government 10-year bond, syempre dapat mas maganda ang return niya versus the government bond. The reason why I'm saying that it depends on interest rates, if for example, interest rates go up and then the government bonds give you a higher return, or let's say 5%. So it is better for you to invest in a government bond because it's risk-free versus a REIT that has risk in it, no? It is not guaranteed by the government. So kung 5% lang ang return mo sa REITs and then 5% yung government bond, mas mabuti pa doon ka na sa government bond. So it depends. If interest rates go up, then it might be more attractive for investors to look at other investments. But if interest rates go down, for example, right now, about around 4% or 4.5%, and then your REIT will give you more about 5-8%, then it becomes a little bit more interesting to invest in a REIT given the risk that it takes versus a risk-free government bond. When you're investing in a REIT, it's your way to diversify your portfolio because it's a hybrid of a fixed income and an equity. It's not entirely a fixed income, it's not entirely an equity, but it's a hybrid of the two, giving you a stable return in terms of dividend as well as the possible upside on the price of the REIT.